I like the fact that here we are with snow outside. Temperature's going to warm up this weekend. And we're talking about the Boilermaker.
July is right around the corner.
It's just around the corner.
And for we'll us, it is.
Right. A lot of stuff to get to. So what are you talking about today? The charity bib is one of the issues that's out there right now.
Well, I hope it's not an issue in the world that we have today. But we have the charity bib that is open.
You have to forgive me because this morning has been nothing but issue after issue.
Yeah.
It's been crazy. Yeah. So charity bib, which is a huge opportunity for local nonprofits to be able to take advantage of the Boilermaker.
Absolutely, yes, take advantage of us. So we're looking for nonprofits that are doing great things in our community to apply for Charity Bib.
What is the requirement?
Be a non-for-profit in the 315. Pretty easy.
That's it.
Yeah.
And how does it work? Are they responsible to reach out to others to run on their behalf? Because I know Andrew usually just picks a charity every year.
Yes, he does.
Yeah, yeah. Been with Citrin the last three,
and it's something
four
we believe in, right? What Citrin does for our veterans and for people with handicap.
Yeah, sports and stuff. Yep.
So
yeah.
There's a couple of ways. Once we announce who we select, they become our partners for the duration, and they can go out and recruit their own runners, or sometimes people are so moved by their stories that they will just say, hey, I want to run for this organization. Yeah. Put me in touch.
Right.
Great, love to.
And what are the requirements this year in terms of money? How much money is there's usually a minimum that you have to raise? So much
still $500. Yeah. So,
and you know, let's be honest, this is a race that that sells out. So when you don't have a bib, it's a great way to get a bib and do some good while you're running.
Yeah, it's a give back opportunity.
Yeah,
why not? Why not?
So I'm a nonprofit. I want to get involved. They fill out the application. Where do they go? Is it on the website? How do we?
It's right on the website. If you go to Boilermaker.com, there's a charity bib application title. Okay. Click on it.
And then aren't you you're doing something with the public market?
We are. So I've partnered with the Oneida County Public Market. We're doing Farmers Food and Fitness, and this is going to be an event on February 24th. But right now we're looking for vendors that are gyms, yoga studios, dance studios, anyone having things to do with nutrition, basically healthier living. And we're going to have this event, and it's kind of a one-stop shop, healthy food, farm food, and opportunities to figure out what might work for you. Some people don't necessarily like running, but yoga might be their thing, or they might enjoy dance or boxing even.
Right.
So we want to put the community in touch.
Pretty cool. And times of all of that, when is that coming up again?
So the application for the Farmers Food and Fitness is also on our website, so you can go download it, get it to me. But that event is February 24th, and we'll hopefully have our charity bib partners announced by March 1st. The application deadline for that is February 16th.
All right, so get them in now if you want to get in there. All right, really cool. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And before you know it, the St. Patrick's Day parade will be over, and we'll be heading straight towards the Boilermaker, waiting for nice weather.